Also, we've come to the structure. The forbidding gap also shows the similarity of both ceiling and supermarket. Now, because the element in terms of the structure is built. Where you have electrons here, this is the Venus then. And this is the production then. And between the bends, alright, there is a gap for semiconductors. There is a small gap.
Yeah.
Alright? Now that calls the electrons to form the conduction of the area of potential difference so that there will be flow of what? Electricity. Okay? So there is a small gap. But for semiconductors, the forbidding gap, as I say, is very, very small. But for superconductors, no forbidding gap. Nothing. Both of them are together. Alright? And last thing in terms of the similarity, which I'll close on, is that we have a band overlap. In terms of band overlap, you'll see that for semiconductor, it looks like this. There's no overlapping of the band. They don't come together. So you have this space. There is a forbidding gap here, which is like 1.1 electron volt. Forbidding gap there. So there is no band overlap. But for superconductors, you have both band. The valence band here and the conduction band together, so there is no band overlap.